Hello friends, most welcome to English Advantage online classes. Friends, in this video we will discuss new pattern English questions for all banking exams like IBPS, PO, clerk and other banking exams. So let us get started. Now before I proceed further, I would like to inform you regarding this online target batch at www.bankerspoint.org. If you want to join it, you can join it by signing up at this site, then log in, then choose your course, and the moment you finish your online payment, your course is activated and you can watch online classes at this particular site, www.bankerspoint.org. Regarding any query, just give me a call on this number 9893719933 and I will sort out your problems and queries. So these are the new pattern questions. These questions are called and they come in the category of phrase replacement, or you can say sentence improvement, although they are not the same. But this is a question of phrase replacement. So in this video tutorial, I have included a new pattern question, 10 questions I have included in this video classes. So this is the question number one. Although scared of heights, she gathered all her courage and stood atop the 24-story building to participate in the activities. Now, the fastest way to solve all these questions is to understand the basic concept of grammar. Just see the tense. This tense is written in past tense, and the past tense is indicated by the verb stood. So that is why you have to write this entire sentence into the past tense. Now you have to change this gather into gathered and your sentence will be correct. She gathered all her courage. So in question number one, your answer will be B, that is, she gathered all her courage and stood atop the 24-story building to participate in the activities. Now let us see the question number two. Naturally, with everything gone so well for them, it was time for celebration. Since everything was going so well for them, the luck was with them, and everything was favoring with them, this is what the sentence want to say. It was time for celebration. So these kind of sentences are normally written in continuous tense. You have to say, naturally, with everything going so well, since everything was going in favor of them, it was time for celebration. Okay, that is how I can interpret the sentence. And in these kind of sentences, we always use ing form of the verb. So here you have to say everything going so well. Naturally, with everything going so well for them, it was time for celebration. Okay, here I'm also explaining important vocabulary for you for other banking exams and SSC exams, like affront and foment. Affront means offend or upset or insult, or slight or outrage. Very many synonyms I have included here. Very important word. This word has been used many times in comprehension, in close test, para jumble. So all these words I have included here. So along with these questions, you can learn these words also. So it will definitely help you a lot. Affront means offend, and foment means to stimulate or to provoke someone, to excite someone. Okay, now let us go ahead and see the question number third. The ban was imposed by the State Tax Commercial Department last Friday after protest by certain communities which had threatened. Now here this had must be followed by third form of the verb, and the third form of the threat is threaten, and rest everything is correct. We cannot say who, because we are not talking about people, we are talking about communities. So here your correct answer will be threatened. Okay, so D will be your correct answer, which had threatened to burn cinema halls. C will be the correct answer, not D, because in D there is a word called hall. We cannot say hall, we have to say halls, because halls is more logical. Which had threatened to burn cinema halls. And what is the meaning of revamp? Revamp means to create something something again, do up or refurbish or overhaul. So this is the meaning of revamp. Very important word. Now let us go ahead and see the question number four. Yogesh Dhable, an avid football player who captained his team in school and college, will inaugurate the match tomorrow in Pune. Okay, so obviously here we are talking about one future incident, one future event that will take place tomorrow. We are not talking about something that will continue to do, continue to go on. So consequently, we cannot use future continuous tense, because activity will not go on. It will happen at a certain time. It will inaugurate. So definitely, this sentence is already correct. Will inaugurate the match is okay. And here your answer will be no correction required. Now see the vocabulary things. Awaste means mortified or embarrassed or disconcerted, ashamed. Very important word. Abased. Taken aback means surprised, or bugged means annoyed or bothered. Bugged. Now let us see the question number 5. At a musical night organized for them, the artistic side of the doctor came as forward as they sang beautifully and made the evening truly memorable. We are talking about the doctors, and in honor of the doctors, one musical night was conducted, and in the musical night they performed very well, and their talent came to the fore. Okay, their talent was visible in front of everyone to see. So definitely here your correct option will be came to the fore. Came to the fore means it became visible. The talent became visible for the audiences. So here your answer is came to the fore. We cannot say came forward, because came forward is used in the physical sense when somebody come ahead or come forward. So came forward will be totally out of context here. Came to the fore is correct answer here. Now let us see the vocabulary things here. Feted means honor or entertain someone, or enthralled means spellbound, fascinated, rapt or captivated. Very important words. Now let us move ahead. Jodie Foster made quite a splash in the film Taxi Driver. Okay, since we are talking about the past tense, so made is okay, and quite a splash is also correct. When you make a splash, it means you make an impression and you receive a lot of public attention. So since the sentence is talking about the past tense, past time, made is quite okay, and this sentence is absolutely okay. There is no grammatical error, and context-wise also the sentence is correct. So here your correct answer is E, that is no correction required. So that is how you have to approach these sentences. You have to do them with accuracy and with minimum possible time. And you can do it by continuous practice and by understanding the grammatical concept in depth. Feted means honor or entertain, and enthralled means spellbound, fascinated, rapt and captivated. So this I have already explained to you in the previous slide. Now let us move ahead and see the question number 7. 4-5 sentences are already given. 4 sentences are already given, and out of which only one sentence is grammatically correct. So this is a new pattern sentence. This is a new pattern question, and in these kind of question, you have to find out the one sentence that is grammatically correct from all angles. Okay, so in one sentence there are 3-4 mistakes, and in another sentence that is correct, the sentence is grammatically correct from all angles. Now in this sentence, solar manufacturers are getting desperate as they say they have marginalized in the country's ambitious solar energy program. Now this sentence seems to be grammatically correct, but context wise this sentence is incorrect, because in this sentence we are saying that solar manufacturers are getting desperate because they say they have marginalized, but the fact is that government has marginalized them. They think that government has marginalized them, or you can say that they have been marginalized by the government. So definitely you cannot use this sentence in active voice. You have to use passive voice here, because something is being done on solar manufacturers. Solar manufacturers are not doing any action, rather action is doing on them. Okay, government is doing action on them. So that is why you have to use passive voice here. So grammatically or structurally this sentence is correct, but meaning wise the sentence is wrong. Now we cannot say getting in desperate. This in is wrong here, so obviously this sentence is also wrong. And let us see the sentence. Solar manufacturers are getting desperate as they say they have been marginalized in the country's ambitious plan. Now in this sentence we are using the passive voice correctly, And getting desperate is also correct here. So this sentence is correct here. Now in this sentence, we are saying getting desperated. Now this phrase is wrong. We cannot say getting desperated. We have to say getting desperate only. So C is correct here. Okay, so this is a new pattern question, and these kind of questions are normally asked in banking exam mains, not pre. Okay, but they can definitely be asked in pre also. So you should be ready for solving these kind of questions. Now let us see the next question. This sentence is regarding Charminar, and let us see which one is correct one. The city of Charminar remains, this remains is correct because we are talking about the singular noun, that is Charminar. This Da is also okay, we are talking about a particular building, the city of Charminar. Okay, the city with the best quality of living in the country for the third consecutive years. When we say second consecutive year, third consecutive year, fourth consecutive year, so in these kind of phrases we always take singular noun. We cannot say third consecutive years. This is wrong. We have to say third consecutive year only. So this particular phrase make this sentence incorrect. Now let us move ahead and see the second sentence. The city of the Charminar remains the city with the best quality of living in the country. The third consecutive year is correct, but here this Da is wrong here, because before Charminar, that is a proper noun, we cannot put this Da. So this Da, inclusion of this Da, makes this sentence incorrect. Now let us see the next part. The city of Charminar remains the city with, now here Da is missing here, because before the superlative adjectives we have to insert Da here, so this is also incorrect. Now let us see this sentence. The city of Charminar remains, it should be remains. So the absence of S in remain makes this sentence incorrect. So this is also incorrect, and effectively none of the sentence is correct. So here your answer is E, that is none is correct. Let us see the next part. A video of a baby monkey crying over the body of her mother killed by a road mishap. We have to say killed in a road accident. So this sentence is incorrect. And killed in a road accident, we cannot write this sentence in present simple tense, because this is a particular incident that took place in the past. This is not an incident that happens on a regular basis. So definitely we cannot say goes here. We have to say went. Okay. So this sentence, the inclusion of this present simple tense makes this sentence totally incorrect. And let me go through this C part. A video of a baby monkey crying over the body of her mother killed in a road accident. Yes, this is correctly written, because something is killed in a road accident. So definitely this sentence is correct here. Video of a baby monkey crying over the body of her mother killed from a road accident. We cannot say killed from a road accident. We have to say killed in a road accident. So this sentence is correct. This sentence is incorrect. And only C is correct. And your answer in this question number 9 will be C. Now this is another type of question. You have to replace the question that may be incorrect, and you have to replace the incorrect one with the correct one. Okay, if he was to decide to go to college, one would recommend that he plan to go to IIM Ahmedabad. This is a subjunctive mood. This is written in subjunctive mood, and these kind of questions are imaginary. And in imaginary sentences, we have to take were here, and only the option B has this were. So here your answer will be B. Okay, so these are the new kind of questions, and I will continue to upload these kind of videos where I will be explaining all new kind of questions for your pre, for your mains, for your descriptive also. I will upload some videos, and for interview also I will upload some videos. So please continue to watch all my video on this particular channel called English Advantage YouTube channel, and kindly do subscribe if you haven't till now, and kindly press the bell icon button also, so that you keep getting all the videos and all the notifications regarding this channel. So regarding any help, online target batch or any other query, just give me a call on this number 9893719933, and I will sort out your problems. And my email ID is written here. Regarding any query, just give me a call, or you can write to me at this email ID, and I will respond to you definitely. And if you want to purchase online mock test series, you can buy it on this website test.englishadvantage.in, and you can practice online. So thank you very much for watching this video, and I wish you all the best for your bright future. Thank you.